ACE 400 is one of the most secure and robust mid-range system from IBM. Though not in its prime, the ACE 400, or popularly known as IBM i or i series, has a very good install base in banking, insurance and pharmaceutical industries. Unlike Windows or Unix, the ACE 400 is not easily available to get hands-on. As a result, IS/IT auditors find it difficult to understand or audit the system. Whether you are setting a password policy or audit settings, the security in ACE 400 is defined by the settings or system values. The system values define the security characteristics of the server. Hello and welcome to Information Security, Governance, Risk and Compliance. My name is Salvador and today we will learn how to audit ACE 400 in 10 steps. Let's get started. Point number one, system security. Before we dive into the system security settings, it is important to understand the different levels of security in ACE 400. There are 5 levels of security, starting from 10 with least security of the server to the value of 50 being the highest level of security. Let's see what these levels are. At level 10, there is no security. No password is required to log in and users have access to all resources. At level 20, the passwords are required, but users have access to the system. At level 30, the passwords are required and users have access as per their profile. At level 40, resource security and integration risk protection is enforced. At level 50, it is the highest level of security with advanced integrity protection. The parameter that defines the security level is Q security. Ensure that security level system value has been set up as 40. To check the value, use the following command: DSP sysval Q security on the command line. Additionally, also ensure that all the required PTFs, known as program temporary fixes, have been applied as and when shared by IBM. Point number two, users and group profiles. There are 5 different types of users that can be created on the ACE 400. Let's see them. Number one is star user. This kind of users are users with least authorities or rights. Star sysopr, users with operational rights like backup, restore, batch operations, etc. Star pgmr, these are the users with programming capabilities like creating programs, debugging, etc. Star secadm, users with security administration authorities to create users and general administration, etc. Star secoffer, this is the root equivalent of Unix on ACE 400. For all the user profiles, make sure passwords are set to be expired and limit capabilities is set to star yes. Special authorities such as secadmin or star all object have been granted on a business need basis only. Make sure group profiles are created with star none for passwords, thereby preventing login to the system by group profiles. To check the above values, use the command dspusrprf space user profile name. Point number three, password settings. The following system values defined for the password policy as follows. Q password max length identifies the maximum length of the password. Q password minimum length defines the minimum length of the password. Q password required digit specifies whether a digit or numeric value is required in the password. Q password valid program calls for a password validation program. Q password expiry interval, this defines the password expiry, usually 30 or 90 days as per the policy. Q password required difference defines after how many cycles you can repeat the same password. Ensure all the above values are defined as per the password policy for compliance.
Point number four, sign-on or logging settings. The display sign-on information system value determines whether the sign-on information display is shown after signing on. The information includes last login date and time and days remaining for the password to expire. Ensure the value is set to 1. Ensure queue max sign-on, which is maximum number of sign-on attempts, is set to either 3 or 5 as defined as per the policy. Also make sure queue max sign-on action, which means what action to be taken when unsuccessful attempts are reached. System value is set to 2, which is disabling the user profile. Point number 5, device sessions and login limits. Ensure that queue limit device session value has been set as 1. This will reduce users to sign on to different workstations, thereby prevent the likelihood of sharing passwords. Also ensure that the queue limit sec offer system value is set to 1. This will ensure all users with all object authority, special authority, or queue sec offer user profile login is limited to single workstation or console. Point number 6, network settings. Ensure that remote sign-on controls QRMT sign system value has been set up as star reject to prevent remote sign-on. Make sure that automatic device configuration QAuto config value, which configures locally attached device automatically, is set as 0. Ensure the virtual devices QAuto virtual VRT system value has been set up as 0. The default value is 0 ensures that no virtual devices are created automatically, which limits access to the server. Point number 7, audit values. On the ACE 400, security related events are logged to the security auditing journal called QAUDJRN when the auditing function is active. Ensure that ACE 400 auditing facility has been set up for the system value QAUDCTL as star AUDLVL, which means the audit levels. And ensure that the QAUDLVL, which is Q audit level, system values are set to star PGM fail, star aut fail, star delete, star net fail, etc. as per the organization policy requirements. Star PGM fail refers to when a program fails. Star AUT fail is authentication failure. Star delete is when any object is deleted. Star net fail when network related issues are occurred. QAUDENDACN system value is set when auditing fails to write entries to the journal. In this case, the value set for QAUDENDACN has to be star notify, which will notify the relevant users of inability to log audit entries. Point number 8, special authorities, adopted programs and sensitive commands. Let's understand special authorities. There are different types of special authorities given to any user. Star all OBJ is called all object authority. Grants the user to access all resources on the system. This gives the user complete authority on the system. Star SecADM special authority grants user to create, change and delete profiles. Star job control special authority grants the user to manage jobs. Star spool control special authority grants the user to manage spool control functions like modifying, deleting, printing, releasing spool files in the job, etc. Star SaveSys special authority grants the user the authority to save, restore, and free storage for all objects on the system. Star Service special authority grants the user to start system service tools using the star strsst command. This helps the user or the administrator to install patches on the system.
Star Audit Special Authority grants the user the ability to view and change audit settings. Star IOSIS Config Special Authority grants user the ability to configure the system, network and etc.
Check and verify that special authorities like Star OLOBJ, Star Service, Star IOSIS Config and Star Sec Admin are provided to users who are required to perform assigned job function and upon approval. Adopted authority programs are somewhat like sudo in Unix. If you want a user to run a privilege command, create a program or a script with the privilege command and give the user the authority to run that program. The user calls the program but does not have the authority to modify the program or simply runs the program from the command line. Ensure that functionality of such programs called by adopted authority program is documented and reviewed. Authorization list defines the rights of users on various objects. Ensure that the authorization is assigned to user profiles only and should be reviewed regularly. Ensure production libraries and sensitive commands have public authority set as star exclude. This will ensure that other or the rest of the world, as we call in Unix, do not have any rights on the production libraries. Make sure the user parameter in all the job descriptions are set to star required. This will prevent unauthorized users to run any sensitive command or program via submit job command. Point number 9, segregation of production and development environment. Way before the virtualization became popular, IBM AS Foundry had already implemented this concept. It's called logical partitioning or LPAR. Each LPAR has its own processing, memory and identification, as in IP name, IP and system name. Ensure that production, test and development environment are set on different LPARs with unique credentials. Additionally, make sure data files and programs are held in separate libraries. Check and verify that programmers do not have access to production libraries. And finally, point number 10, backup. Ensure backups are scheduled and performed successfully, and the tapes are labeled properly with a write protect button on as to prevent accidental overwrite during usage. Ensure a register is used to record a movement of backup media tapes. The offset location storing the backup tapes should be secured against any form of unauthorized access. Thank you for watching the video. Do provide your feedback and subscribe the channel for upcoming videos. Thank you.